Sophomore year of high school, man. You already know your brother was looking smooth. Smooth as ice and twice as nice. Math class. I love math. Math was my favorite subject in high school and in college. So I'm a math guy, but I hate geometry. Geometry, I hated geometry. Every freaking angle. First day in the class, man, you already know. Your brother scoping the class out and seeing if I see a smooth, fine honey, right? There's a couple cuties in there. Barely. I was that one guy that looked smart and was smart, but not in every subject, okay? You know what I'm saying? I looked like I might know how to, you know, solve a Rubik's Cube on paper. I don't know.
What?
So the ladies were feeling me. The ladies were like, oh snap, I want to work with him because he know how to do his, you know, he's smart. You smart, you know what I mean?
You smart.
Ladies wanted to work with me, so I'm like, yeah, and I was cute too, so you know, your brother was looking sharp at all times. Trust and believe. So this math teacher, right? I'm gonna call him Mr. G. Mr. G, he was a smart dude. He was one of those teachers that was very calculated and very, you know, strategic, and everything that he did was organized, even to the way that he dressed. He dressed so like perfectly, like symmetrical, you know, like his he wore long sleeve shirts that had to be like pulled up, and like they were perfectly folded on both forearms, like equally the same length and everything. It was crazy. And then when he wrote on the board, his writing was so like freaking, was so neat. He was one of them guys that almost drew a perfect circle. Like it looked perfect, but you know, nobody could draw a perfect circle, right? It was like that good, it looked perfect, you know? He was that like calculated, that well put together. So like even when you look on his desk, all the pens are properly placed. You know, he never had like smudges on his shoes. His hair was always intact. He had the two pens right there that never moved. Like this guy was just crazy. Like, and then his posture was straight. You know, every time you see him walk down the hallway, he walked like a robot, son, because he was just like, everything was just so straight. I'm like, why is everything so straight? That's just the way that he was. He was just so organized. He's the type of teacher that you never would see angry. Most of the time you saw him, he wasn't even happy. He was just like a robot, literally. Like he would just do the work on the board and tell us how to do it and ask us if we had any questions. And that's about it, man. He never really had conversation with anybody. He was very mute apart from teaching. He just did the teaching stuff and then that was it. Like everything was robotic with this guy. Everything, I think I only seen him laugh like one time. Yeah, probably like one time, pretty much. So we go through the year, right? I'm thinking I'm doing good in the class because he's explaining everything. I'm understanding how he's explaining it. But the thing was, he didn't do our test. The curriculum did our test, right? So he wouldn't make the test. He would just do problems from like the curriculum, but then we would have a totally different test. Like the test would be on something that he didn't exactly show up. You know how you would do a regular math problem in homework and then see the same problem on the test, but it has like some kind of additional attachment to it that just makes it three times harder? That's what it was like. So he would teach something and you will understand it perfectly, right? When you get to the test, it's totally something different.
Huh?
Stay off the drugs.
What? So the year goes by and I'm actually failing the class. Got like the C. A C minus. I want to get a C plus. I actually want to get a B. I was at a B, but then I dropped down to a C because I had this one test that I got a D on, and it dropped me down to like a C minus.
Congratulations, you played yourself.
Class is very hard, by the way, very hard. Geometry didn't seem that hard, but the tests were just ridiculous. Like all those stupid theorems and formulas. Like, bro, it was just at a certain point. So many of them just made you get confused. Like it's just so many of them you can take in, and after like five, you just don't know which one to use no more. But there's this one time, right? There was this one time where he actually got pissed off. I don't remember exactly what happened, but I think some kid in the class, some girl, because there was a lot of girls in the class, by the way. I had a lot to choose from. it was a lot of girls in the class, and this one girl got him pissed off or angry because she said something. I don't know what she said, but that was the first time I seen him get angry. It was a weird thing to see because he was angry, but he didn't exactly yell. You can see, like, you know how in the horror movies, like, the killer don't scream at you, but you could, you know, based on the body language, you know he's gonna kill you. That's how it was. Like, you knew he was angry based on his facial expression and his body language. And he spoke sternly, but it was very soft. I don't know how to imitate it. I would, but I don't know. Like, this is something that you had never seen before. I've never seen it before, ever. But that's how he expressed his anger. Like, he was just like, you could feel the room temperature change. That's how crazy it was. So when I seen him get angry for the first time, I'm like, oh snap, let's see what he's about to do. You know, I'm ready to see what he got. But it wasn't really anything like you would expect because it was different. He expressed his anger differently. So ended off the year with like probably a C. I barely passed. Toward the end of the year, a lot of girls still work with me because you know, your bro was, you know, pretty. That was cute, right?
Barely.
I forgot to add this note in there. He had a sister. I don't know if it was his twin sister or what, but he had a sister. Next year comes by and I'm a junior now. You know, I'm excited for the next year. This is a public school, by the way. And I hear like some rumor going around about somebody not being here this year, a teacher not being here this year based on some traumatic events. I don't remember exactly how I found out, but somebody told me, right? They said, hey, you remember Mr. G, right? That used to teach geometry. I'm like, yeah, I remember him. You know, the guy that always wore everything like neat and, you know, he had perfect posture and crap, right? Yeah, what about him?
He died.
What do you mean he died? Apparently, he had committed suicide. Now, I don't want to go into detail on how he killed himself because this video might get scratched off or something. I don't know. But he committed suicide. I don't know why he did it. Looking back on how he was in class, this dude never smiled, barely. He was always monotone. Like, he just didn't look like he enjoyed life, really. You know, he probably enjoyed his job, but I don't think he enjoyed life. Everything was just so like weird with the guy, like in the way of like he had to do everything neatly and everything was strategic. Like, he left the same time every day. He just worked like a robot. He just kept, everything was the same. Everything. It was crazy. But he had died and he had killed himself, you know, with a self-inflicting wound. I don't want to get into detail about that again. Word has gone around in the school that he did that, and I was just so surprised. I remember back at the time when I was in his class, a lot of people would pick on him, not during class, but a lot of people would say stuff about him, like after class or like around the school, like, oh, this guy's kind of, you know, strange, bop, bop, bop. You know, so maybe that might have gotten to him. I don't know. He probably had some outside affairs that, you know, made him come to that conclusion. Or he was just probably never a happy person. I don't know. You know, obviously something was wrong. But I was sad to hear that news. I was kind of hurt by it because he was a good teacher. But, you know, he had some issues that he couldn't come to a conclusion with, I guess. And he took his own life. Moral of the story, man, is every teacher that you meet, talk to them, you know, be nice to your teacher, show some respect to your teacher, love your teacher, you know, try to be a bright energy toward your teacher, just to make somebody's day go smoother or something. I don't know, that might change the perspective or change how some people value the day. You know, maybe no one really spoke to him. He seemed like probably the guy that no one spoke to it back when he went to school or something like that. Like, he probably had no friends really, I don't know. But it seemed like that. So, moral of the story is, treat others well. You know, always touch others that you wouldn't normally speak to. You know, speak to them because everybody needs somebody, and you could be that somebody. So, with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this story time. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. See you guys next video.